That's my door burning, by the way.
We'll have fun.
Or not.
Hi, Benji. That's all right. That's all right.
So this.
I love you.
This film is called For Benji.
Yes.
Why don't we start by the first time you met Benji?
Ooh, okay. First time I met Benji, I was at American Eagle, obviously. And I didn't really like him at first because he's very handsome. And obviously, like, you know, I know I'm really handsome. I'm obviously a 10. But when I see another 10, like, I automatically go into predator mode, right? I don't like to see other 10s. I don't like it. It's sick. It makes me upset. You do that way too well. It makes me upset. So, didn't like Benji at first. And then after the first half a minute of talking to him, I realized, oh balls, this guy's freaking awesome. What
now,
have I gotten myself into now?
Did Benji still have long hair when you first met him?
Nope. It was really short.
Do you think that it's possible that your love for Benji has something to do with the fact that he once had long hair, and at that time you were longing to have your hair long?
My love for Benji does not have to do with anything of him having long hair. Actually, when I first met him, I had kind of long hair. I think I had semi-dreads when I first met him, but they were, like, super short. And it was before I started really taking care of him, so, started really not taking care of him. So it's really short. And no, I don't think so. I think my my love for Benji definitely has something to do with the fact that we are twins, fraternal and identical both, and that we are just super awesome with each other, and we think the same thing. And I know the word for that is ESPN, or silly of me, ISP, and definitely I think that's what where my love for Benji comes from. We're the same person. We almost feel the same things, except of when we are in the middle of fornicating. Then we block each other out, because it's weird.
Can you...
I've done a lot of cocaine, so no, I don't. I don't really recall the first conversation I had with Benji.
Have you really done a lot of cocaine?
Yes.
Are you forgetting to repeat the questions?
I'm sorry. I have really done a lot of cocaine. Cocaine's a hell of a drug.
Are you an honest person?
Absolutely not. I'm not an honest person. I would say I like to lie for jokes about 85% of the time. Other 15%, I might be telling the truth.
Do you think you're a funny person?
No, I just think I'm... I do not think I'm that funny of a person. I think I'm just kind of weird. I would like to say that I'm kind of quirky, is the word I'm looking for.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's higher than the devil's dick in here right now. Go ahead.
Now, you say you joke about 80% of the time.
85, yes.
85? Do you think you use humor as a wall or a guard?
Every funny person will tell you that they use humor as a guard.
Or a defense mechanism.
Every funny person will tell you they use humor as a guard or defense mechanism. It's obvious.
Now, what do you have to defend?
I don't know. I don't know what I have to defend. I'm a semi-guard person. I don't have very many friends. I don't like very many people. I mean, I like people, but I don't like to hang out with very many people. I am somewhat antisocial. Yes.
I think you're social.
Well, yeah, like, I'm social when I am semi-social, but I am only social when I have to.
So you're reserved.
I would say that, yes, I am indeed reserved.
Do you want to talk about stereotypes? Let's talk about stereotypes.
Talk about... I'm black as hell. I love grapes. As a matter of fact, yeah, I got grape drink in the refrigerator as we speak. Grape is the best flavor of anything. Grape Down Layers, grape Jolly Ranchers, freaking grape Laffy Taffies, obviously, grape juice, / drink, / pop. Grape is like the best flavor of anything. And it's also the healthiest because it has riboflavin. Obviously, grape Kool-Aid makes me excited. Who doesn't love grape?
Philip, if you were in trouble with the law, what would it be for?
Probably like, I probably am currently in trouble with the law. I am, like, 3 years ago? Like, I am, it was like 2 years ago. I don't know. Maybe 2 years ago. I was driving home to Kankakee back when Methuselah, the name of my 1999 Ford Taurus, sweetly ever, once she gets a new battery. But yeah, I was driving home, and I got stopped in Effingham for going 71 in the 65. I don't know why I got stopped that day. Anyway, my registration was expired. And so the cop, he was like, "Oh, snaps, do you have enough money to pay for it?" I was like, "Yeah, I have." He was like, "It's $75. I was like, "Cool, I have 80. Do you have change?" He's like, "No, we don't carry change. Give me your driver's license."
Brittany!
Brittany, please don't talk. Brittany, please don't talk while I'm in the middle of my interview. All right, this doesn't have anything to do with you.
Yeah, we want to make sure that we want to make sure everybody in the audience knows that Philip is the main person here, not Brittany.
Please get your stuff going, okay. So I can finish my anecdote.
Yeah, audience, please understand that Philip is the main person here, not Brittany. Brittany is not stealing the spotlight from Philip. We're
please
not
take
let,
your yeah. Northeast shirt.
Yeah, we're not
going to
let
somewhere.
Yeah, we're not going to let Brittany the steal the center of attention from Philip.
Go blow yourself. If you could blow yourself, would you try?
Yes, we'll edit that. We'll edit that out later. We're gonna edit this out. But yes, if I could suck my own penis, I would never leave my room. I would not need women. I'd probably be a very productive person, because I'd be sucking my dick and reading books.
Would you feel gay?
It's not gay if you suck your own dick.
Are you sure?
Yes, it's more cannibalism than it is gay. No, I would not secrete semen into my mouth, though. I'm a gentleman. I don't do that.
Have you ever tasted your own semen?
No.
Never?
No, I know a guy who eats his own semen, though, because it's easier to clean up. No, the guy's not me. I know that's going to be your next question. Oh, it was not going
to
be that.
Let's go back to you got pulled over.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, I got pulled over. The guy took my license away. He was like, "Yeah, you got to pay your ticket." So I was just like, "Fine, I'll pay my ticket." I paid my ticket. I sent the money order in the mail. And never got my, and they were like, "Yeah, we'll just send back your license." I never sent back my license. And so, like, there could be a warrant out for my arrest, but I've been apprehended by the cops since then. So I don't think I have a warrant out for my arrest, so I'll be okay.
Do you drive without a license?
Yes.
I drive without a license, is how you answer that.
Oh, sorry. Yes, I do drive without a license. This is not going to go out to them.
This is going out to everybody.
Okay, I just...
Do you have insurance?
I do.
Because it would be icing on the cake if you drove...
No, I have insurance. My mom pays my insurance. Let's say if I had to pay for my own insurance, I probably wouldn't have insurance.
Have you ever thrown up ice cream?
No, I've never thrown up ice cream. I never do that. I love ice cream.
Try to keep it down?
Yeah, like, I don't really eat ice cream that much. I try to stay away from dairy products.
They make you gassy.
Because... Is it because I'm lactose intolerant?
Are you? Do you have sickle cell anemia too, Philip?
What my interviewer is trying to say right now is she was asking if I am lactose intolerant or if I have sickle cell anemia, because I happen to be African American, and those two conditions are prevalent in the African American community.
Well, I just want to remind the audience, because everyone
says
you're the white black guy,
checked.
So I just don't want them to forget while you're talking who you are.
Thank you. Other than that, I don't really do anything outside of the law. Like, I still haven't got a new registration, it's like 2 years expired. But,
Oh, that's not good, folks.
I don't give a shit. Yeah, so, but other than that, I live with them inside law. I don't really do anything else illegal. I download movies.
Just the Secretary of State. Like, you snub the Secretary of State, but everything else you do is legit.
First of all, Jesse White's a bitch, and he knows that.
Why?
Why is he a bitch? I don't really know. He's actually a pretty nice guy. I've seen him.
You've met him?
No, I've seen some interviews, so he's, like, very soft-spoken. And he's African-American.
Yes, he is. What happened to the light? It just
quit? It just went off.
Yeah.
Oh.
He's really cool, though. I like Jesse White. Actually, he has a thing called the Jesse White Tumblers, and they actually do flips and shit like that. and I've seen them perform live.
He's a cheerleading squad?
No, they're like, no, it's just like dudes and chicks who can do flips and somersaults and
like cheerleading gymnastics?
No cheerleading, no, they don't have pom-poms or short skirts. I mean, it's like gymnastics.
Gymnastics, yeah.
Have you ever done any gymnastic tricks?
I have never done any gymnastic tricks. However, when I was younger, I wanted to be I used to watch the Olympics, and I used to want to do like the floor exercises. But needless to say, that never worked out.
My favorite was always the rings.
What? Yeah. Rings are so lame. Nah, it's like the people who run east to west or side to side doing flips and shit. I don't like when they do the dancing though, because that's freaking lame. But doing the flips, that stuff's awesome.
If you're gonna get tatted up, but you could only get the tattoo on your chest, right where Dallas's big ass skull is,
sure. Yeah.
What you gonna get?
I'm gonna get. I'm finna get. If I got a tattoo and it was only could be on my chest, I was wanting a drum machine tattoo, like an Akai NPC, like head on my chest.
A what?
Akai NPC. Drum machine.
Speak English for the
Akai MPC. Drumheads know what I'm talking about.
Non-drumheads, explain.
It's a drum machine. A drum machine is like a, you know, if you listen to a lot of dance music, you hear boom, boom, boom. Those claps aren't really claps from like actual people. Those are claps are synthesized claps that tons of audio engineers like crafted over a year's work. It's like all kinds of those. It's like 808 claps, there are 909 claps, there are 80s vintage claps. There's like a shit ton of claps. But anyway, a drum machine is a machine that has all the sounds. It has like the boom, like huge kick drums that you might hear in a Gucci Mane song or like a any kind of dance song. Mostly any kind of rap song. They're made with drum machines. Also, you can sample drum machines with them. So, or you can sample with drum machines. For example, if I, let's see, this Kaiwa song. That's a Jamie Foxx sample. Well, it's a Ray Charles sample, but Jamie Foxx sung over it. Anyway, that was sampled. Anyway, you put that in a drum machine, so you just press the button, and I say, give me money. Then another button might say, when I'm in need. So I'm like, give me money, when I'm in need. And then it loops it, and then you can do like a boom. Give me money. Boom, boom. Well, it would be a kick on another pad. Anyway, yeah, that's what I have. Because I love drum machines.
Do you have one?
I used to.
What happened to your drum machine?
I sold it.
For how much money?
$500.
Do you think that was fair?
Yeah, because I ended up getting like I ended up buying a digital camera and Pro Tools with it. And Pro Tools is like a drum machine for your finger. So. I thought I got a pretty fair deal with it.
Good.
I still miss it though sometimes, but it's alright. I need to get it. I always wanted to get a new one though.
So Philip's in fourth grade writing short stories.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm in fourth grade writing stories. And the funny thing about it is, I was young. I didn't know what the joke was. But anyway, I had a stepdad and brother. And I would say, hey, read my stories. And they'd be like, yeah, awesome. And they would always laugh when they read the front cover. And I was like, that's freaking lame. I haven't read the story yet. And I was like, is it my artwork? And it was no. And I was like, why are they laughing? It's not even that funny. Well, I didn't know it was at the time. I'm young. And it's a different time. And my stepdad and my brother were a bunch of dicks. Anyway, the name of my horror stories, fashioned after the Goosebumps, they're called Query Theories. I was like, why do they laugh? It was called Query Theories. And needless to say, I figured out why. Got so immature.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah. I actually gave him, my fourth grade teacher was named Miss Gilbert. And she read them and she really enjoyed them. She said I was a good writer.
So you wish you had pursued writing?
I write every day. I still write. Just don't write. So
okay, we're gonna play some games now. Test your knowledge.
All right.
We're start with spelling.
Okay.
Can you spell cunnilingus?
CUNNILINGUS.
I don't know if that's right or not. I just thought that was a funny word.
What does that mean?
Well, why don't you tell us what it means?
Fellatio. Oh, female. Well, I don't know if you call it. It can't be fellatio because which stems from phallus. And phallus obviously means penis. It's oral sex, so, you know.
How does fellatio come from phallus?
Fellatio, phallus, they sound almost the same.
Yeah, but it's a PH and an F word, so I don't see how they're derived from the same...
They're derived from the same word.
Are they really? Like...
Yes.
Really?
Yes! Why can't... Why is it called being fellatio?
But, like, I really don't think fellatio comes from phallus.
Agree, disagree.
I was just wondering if you genuinely knew that or not.
I figured.
If not, I'm going to ask my teacher tomorrow, because he's, like, an English major.
You ask him if fellatio comes from phallus?
Yeah, I talk to him every day about my project, which is a porn store, so...
That's awesome.
He's creepy and likes it. If you had to put a price on your life, like, say you committed a really bad crime and there was a price on your head, how much do you think it would be?
I think it might start out a little bit, it'll appreciate. But, it'll probably start out at, like, price on my head? What is the crime that I'm committing?
Well, I'm just saying, like, if you just had to put a price on yourself.
Like, how much do you think I'm worth? How much do I think I'm worth?
No, because person's worth is, like, different, but, like... I mean, just number value for what's tangible. Do you need to talk to some, like, Thailand slave owners to, like, know, like, how much people 10, 000, are worth these days?
10,000 human dollars. It would be the price on my head. And then, since I am crafty...
Really, I'd put more on it because you got nice dreads.
Well, thank you. Listen, things are worth more than $10,000. That's why she's my friend. I don't... I'd say $10,000, but appreciate. And I'm crafty, so you wouldn't be able to find me. So eventually, it'll probably be up to $1 billion because I could stay in the same place for forever.
Mm-hmm. So, like, if Bill Gates came to you and was like... Philip, I want you to be my personal assistant, but I'm going to pay you in one lump sum, and you have to work for me until I die.
What is Bill Gates' health like?
I don't know. He's, like, in his 50s and probably...
Is he healthy? Is he running every day? Does he take a multivitamin? Does he have a high-fiber diet? Does he have high cholesterol? Does he have a heart problem? Does he have cancer?
No.
He's just healthy. He's just a normal guy.
He's just average. He'll
probably be like 30 years. I don't know. He doesn't have a high stress job, so he might live to he's like 75. I'm gonna say he lives to he's 80. And I'm just be a personal assistant. It was one lump sum. I don't really require much to live. I just require comic books, vegetables, bread, and water, and the internet, and a nice computer. I can drive a shitty car, I don't give a shit about that. So, I basically need to live comfortably for a year. I would say $50,000. That's to live comfortably. So, I would say, whatever 50 times 30 is.
$1.5 million.
$5 million.
I could live off $100,000 a year and ask for $3 million.
No, I don't want $100,000 a year. I believe excess negates progress.
How are you with money control? Like, if you were to have that 1.5 up front, would you be able to allocate it $50,000 a year, or do you think that you might gloriously spend and hope he dies early?
I would trust in the banking system, and I would just have an account set up where just give me $50,000. No. Give me an allowance of 50 divided by 12 is a year, and just give me that every month, and then
I think it's like
$4,500 a month. Put the rest in a, and then put some of that in a Roth IRA, let it appreciate. No, I can retire when I'm 50.
No, you retire in Bulgarian status.
Well, I'm assuming he's gonna die when he's 30 something, so I retire when he's 80 something, so I retire when I'm like 50 something.
How many rubber bands do you have in your hair?
I don't know. I don't know how many rubber bands I have in my hair. I lost count a long time ago.
If someone cut a dread...
Somebody cut a dread, I'd be really upset. think you'd be a really good friend, and I'll be really upset. And it's really bad to be attached to someone like that. But.
Because I was thinking that it would be really funny. Philip, just hear me out here.
I'm listening, but I'm going
to
say no
say
already.
Say I go to Walmart, I go to the arts and crafts section, and I get a, like, make your own keychain kit.
You want to go to Hobby Lobby for that.
Well, they're not open now. And we make a keychain for Benji. Out of one of your, just one dread.
I love Benji a lot.
Would you do that?
I would not do that.
You would not do that?
No.
Philip, how funny would that be?
It would be freaking hilarious.
What if we took one, like, out of the bottom side, like, in the back, where no one would even know it was gone?
I'll throw everything off. It's just, I've grown attached to them over time.
But you don't even know that some of them, which one's your favorite, by the way?
I don't have a favorite dread. I love them all equally.
Please, please, Philip. That's awesome.
What are you going to give me if I do it?
I'll make the keychain.
Okay, well, thank you. No, I would not. I love Benji. He is freaking awesome. I can't cut my hair. Anything else?
That is a really good idea, though, right?
That's an amazing idea. That's a really good
point. I mean, your twin is leaving.
I know.
You don't know when you're... I mean, you know when you're going to see him next.
I do know I'm going to see him next.
You don't know how long the next period of time will be.
Yeah, I do. It's going
to
be 2 weeks.
Don't you want him to be able to just, like, rub that between his finger thumb?
No.
And just be like, my twin.
Well, thank God for the internet and Skype. He'll see me all the time. He'll see my... I'm sorry. I know, I really should, but I can't. I'm growing attached.
Maybe you could think about it.
Yeah, I'll let marinate.
Because you might decide in an hour that that's a really kick-ass idea.
I might.
I'm obsessed with it because it just came to me and I was like, yo, that would be so sweet to bead a dread and put it on a keychain for Benji.
I would have to do a lot of cocaine. But
which isn't a problem because you do cocaine.
I do cocaine often. Like, back home, they call me Cokehead. And that's only because I drink a lot of Coca-Cola. But they don't really know that I'm actually... I love cocaine.
Hey, you come in.
Ah!
I heard we were filming up here.
Yeah, dude!
What are we doing? For Benji?
Yeah. I'm all loving right. That freaking... That's what, you hear Kobe might play in freaking Turkey or something?
I think it's a rumor, though. They said the one team that was going after him was...
They don't have enough money.
Is this Corey?
Yeah.
Corey, are you in the shoe?
I'm about to be.
No, you're in it. No, you have to get over a little bit. We can't see you. We can hear you.
Hey, guys.
Dip in, man. No, just walk over. Yeah, sit down. Yeah, sit down. You can actually interview him.
Do you freaking hear about, like, freaking the team that got Darren Williams?
Besiktas?
Yeah, Besiktas. That was a soccer team, too.
That's the team that got in trouble for... fixing matches and shit.
Yeah. Soccer game tomorrow night.
Who's playing?
I don't know. Benji's parents.
Oh, yeah, he was talking about that. Like,
is it Paraguay? Oh, shit, it's Uruguay versus, it was going to be freaking Uruguay versus, like, Argentina or some shit, but.
Are we filming for Benji or what?
This is for Benji.
Tell me the story behind this recording.
Well, this is.
Well, we were just kind of messed up one night, and I thought it was really funny to while Philip was in our absence, to sign him up for a documentary, and Jamie took the idea and ran with it, you know?
Okay.
So we're
all right. You had the idea, and he had the motivation.
Sweat equity. And we got the willingness right here.
If you want to think of 5 to 10 quick questions, like, you want to ask Philip while we converse, and then we'll do them right before you go back downstairs.
I already know his first question. Kobe Bryant is my favorite player in the NBA, and he's probably the best leader.
This is a documentary all about
that
Philip.
That's the answer.
Philip is the main person here.
And I haven't asked, like, favorite color birthday. So
give me like a sample question. Like, what are we doing here? Like,
quick fire questions. Which favorite color?
But if you want
to ask him,
yeah,
you're
going to
want to know about Philip. So what do you
what
want?
What size jeans do you wear? You know, just random.
32, 34.
I don't know.
Well, it's like whatever the first couple.
We
questions.
Asked him.
Yeah.
It's called the fist bump.
There you go. Yeah, you guys are being cool and hanging out.
How
together.
Is this for Benji though? I don't understand it.
Because me and Benji are twins.
Well, we think the title for Benji is edgy and artsy, so it's just we're taking it around.
I'm sorry. What was this hangout, and why the hell was I not invited? I love marijuana. I don't smoke it, but I love it. I didn't think I was invited. Do you know I do like wifely dudes like cook, clean. Be loyal to your man.
Yep. Yeah. I don't think Benji would make Philip die. I think Benji would try to arouse the voodoo doll so that Philip had a permanent hard-on all the time and couldn't go anywhere.
Did you know?
So were you scared when you got your first erection? I actually remember the first time I realized it felt good to touch yourself. And I've never told this story before, but I feel like this is a good opportunity.
That's the best opportunity.
Should I turn the camera towards you?
No.
Why not?
No, and I was originally going to save this story for my first, like, porn interview. I'm going to tell it. I feel like this is the time.
Are we the only two that are ever going to hear it, or what?
Well, Jamie Ellis.
And the world.
Damn it!
We
okay, all right, no,
shut
no.
It off. All right, I can
I'm
wait until you, like,
I'm
no.
Just kidding.
So, like, as I was six, and I'm watching this Steve Martin film. I think it was Steve Martin. I'm not sure. I don't know what it was called. But in the film, like he is him, but, like a woman gets put into his body, too. Like, something weird happens. It's almost like Freaky Friday, but...
Jamie
like,
Lee Curtis, please, once you want, man.
But, like, some, like, British lady takes over, like, the right half of him or something. And he can see her in the mirror, but he looks like him or whatever. Anyways, the situation was, it was the first time he had to go pee in public. And so she had to, like, hold the dick because she was the right side. And I don't know why
just
I thought...
You can't hold your dick with your left hand.
I don't know why I thought it would be funny to pretend like I was a guy, like, peeing. Because I just thought it was weird that guys stood up. Because I was six, I didn't know. Wow. And so, like I was just, like, reenacting the movie with my hands here. And I was like, that feels good. That's where
okay.
I'm from there. 6 years old.
It's pretty young.
Dude, how often do you work out? You're freaking ripped.
Well, not anymore, really. But, like, I do go... Probably like 5 or 6 times a week.
You ever take roids? Never?
I've been up here. I have.
You know what's weird is it's been coming in waves, and I'm just kind of like wondering.
That's what
she said. That was good.
Can you do that?
In waves?
I think so. If you have enough.
Oh, okay,
that.
Maybe.
No.
Okay. Possible.
I mean, I've seen some crazy stuff, but I'm not the person shooting it, so I don't know what it feels like. What does it feel like when you ejaculate?
This is a question for me?
Documentary.
What does it feel like to ejaculate? Like, you ever, like, have to pee really bad?
And it feels awesome?
Yeah, it feels awesome. Or no! You ever have to shit really bad? And, like, it feels amazing, like, when you get on the toilet seat and, like,
yeah,
shit.
I like the peeing
like
reference
anal.
Better.
Yeah, this does sound like anal. Never mind. It's not like anal, but...
No, it is like anal. Anal sex feels like when you have a really good shit. And the fact that guys admit that really good shits feel good means that you would enjoy anal if you did it.
I don't think so.
I guarantee. I mean, you might not enjoy the fact that you're being porked in the ass. I quoted Brittany there.
That's exactly how she would say it.
But if you could get over the fact that you were, you know, doing that.
Have you had sex with the man that asked before?
Yeah.
No. You misunderstood my question. Had you penetrated a man in the ass? Okay.
I can never put on a strap on. Could you?
No, I don't think I would need to.
I have enough dicks as it is.
Yeah, after you get back.
What if you like had like 3 chicks?
You guys have less than 2 dicks.
And you had 2 strap-ons, one on each knee, and that's... then you had the third girl like on your lap, and you were like doing this.
That
you'd never do that.
No.
Why not?
Why
would I have dicks on my knee?
You'd be fucking 3 girls at once. That's
I don't.
Awesome
no,
sport.
No. My knees are boning 2 girls, and I'm boning a girl. I'm boning 1 girl and 2 girls are alone.
I wouldn't feel any
so
better.
You don't consider like it like fucking a girl if you use something on her?
I consider one of my orifices penetrating the other girl. No, I'm sorry.
You
my
call
dick.
A penis an orifice?
No, because I was saying
like
my
are
hand.
You inverted?
Yeah. That'd be awesome. I like when ooh, when everybody's young, he's able to contract his dick into his body. True story.
I've heard that.
But once your penis grows, it doesn't work anymore.
I've heard that it's just like one day you wake up and it's just bigger. Like it goes from being little boy to being like adult.
Overnight.
Yeah, that's
damn.
What I've heard.
Not
I don't
yet,
know if that's true or
not. Holy shit! It's so big. Not that it wasn't before, but it's a lot bigger. It's probably the biggest dick I've ever seen.
It's great. Like I
plus
feel
a few
like
inches.
I don't remember when like my
is this going on the internet?
No. This okay. Part
I was so pissed.
I want to be in the extras at least.
Deleted scenes. I was so pissed. Is it weird having a vagina?
Yeah. It's real hard to keep clean.
Oh.
Because you have to like dig around in there.
Fun.
You know, you think shaving your balls is scary. Think about having to spread open some lips and make sure that's clean.
I don't shave my balls.
That's fun.
All right.
You shave?
Well, I don't shave them. I trim them.
Yeah.
Like a bush.
I feel like you need something there. Like, I just can't.
The damn jungle between
If you're not going to have ball hair, you better just wax everything. You
know? It makes it look bigger, though, if you freaking wax.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't shave.
Not at all?
Nope.
You don't groom down there at all?
Nope.
And you wonder why you don't get regular lays?
That's first of all the women that I've been with.
Haven't complained?
Exactly. But I don't like oral sex, and I think it's
Did you know that most customers don't complain, they just stop shopping at the store?
You're an asshole.
I don't understand your analogy.
She's trying to say
I'm just
that.
He's giving me a hard time.
That's what she said.
I'm
but,
sweating.
But not more than once, because they don't shop in the same store twice.
Right. No, I think Phillip's a stud.
Thank you.
I've heard that you've gotten your fair share of hood rats.
I have a connoisseur of hood rats.
Just to clarify, are you reading from a book of questions?
No.
Just...
This is all improv.
Corey, you like hood rats?
Hood rats. Yeah. See, I was about to ask you, how do we define a hood rat?
Oh, thank you. I was hoping
Best question ever!
How do I define a hood rat?
Start your sentence with a hood rat is. I know you're going to, but I just want to clarify that.
A hood rat is a girl who, she doesn't have, like, the best morals, and she will do some low-down stuff to have a penis inside of her, and she's not really a nice person, but she put up with it because she sleeps with you. And she probably doesn't look all the best. She doesn't really keep herself well groomed or anything like that, but you put up with it because under the throes of passion, all you need is a necklace.
Okay.
Get your mat and get out.
Thank you. Hood rats don't sleep over.
They don't?
Hood rats don't sleep over. Hood rats
kick on the ass.
Hood rats say, alright, thanks, I got something to go do. Make it out.
See, the great thing about hood rats and why I respect them as people, they know that you're not sleeping over. They know that you're about to go over there, do what you gotta do.
Can they come to your place if they're hood rats?
Hood rats usually don't come to my place.
Can they?
You go to them.
If they do come over to your place, do they become something more than a hood rat? Or less than a hood rat?
If they come over to place number one, I make sure my roommate's gone, because I don't want them to know the filth that I bring into...
Okay.
We live in a trailer, and I call it filth that we bring to the trailer.
Alright.
These are like redneck hood rats.
Can there be a redneck hood rat?
Yeah, there can be, and if you know one, I want to meet her.
Okay.
She has to be a hood rat, though. I don't want to be just a straight-up redneck who has morals and values. Uh-uh.
Okay.
I need a redneck hood rat.
I got plenty
of those in my sorority. You know my
what's sorority?
I can't tell you. I'm a recruitment counselor.
Can I play my song for you guys?
Yeah, let's hear it.
Here you go.
I don't have a plug-in.
He doesn't
want to
be
in
this. He's here, I'll just take
it. So how do you know about Benji?
I work with him. And he's my twin.
He's a twin?
Yep. Fraternal and identical.
Wait, we don't want to repeat stuff. Philip, don't repeat answers. Tell him it in a different way.
Benji is not only my fraternal twin, but he's also my damn identical twin. I don't know how else I can repeat that. That is a flower.
I want you to think of the most uncomfortable question you would never want to answer, and I want you to ask it to Philip.
It's hot shit up here.
And I mean go there. Like, go there.
Go there?
Yeah. Shit. Like, I asked him if he's drank his own semen, and he said no, and I don't believe him.
What about urine?
No. I've never drank my own urine. However, if I was stuck in the jungle, I would have to, because not only is it sterile,
doesn't it rain in the jungle? Don't you mean the desert?
Well, it goes urine, rainwater, and then semen. So
if there's a drought in the damn jungle, I'll drink my own semen.
Is the bathroom clear?
No, sorry, drink my own urine.
Yeah.
That's what you came up here for?
Yeah. Sorry, man.
It's all right.
That was his big question. Is the bathroom empty? It seems like... Never mind. What's your favorite spice?
My favorite spice is...
Flavor.
I love sugar, but when we're talking about food, I think my favorite spice... I'm a huge garlic fan. I like garlic a lot. But also, I'm learning to like spicy things. Like in Cajun, a little cayenne. But yeah, I think garlic would be definitely like one of my favorite spices.
Do you...
This is Ryan and Shayla. They're freaking awesome. Pretty much the best couple I've ever met in my life.
We're going to miss you, Benji.
Yes, we will.
This is for Benji, right?
Yes, okay.
It's for Benji, but it's
and
about
And I brought you a dildo.
It's called a silver bullet.
There we go. Not the beer.
Sounds like he already owns one.
Mm-hmm.
But that's okay. The thought is what counts.
So what has everybody else been saying? I don't know what to say.
We're just talking about Philip's life.
It's like a documentary.
This about Benji. It's about Philip.
No, it's about your life. You want Benji, but it's about Philip.
So what do you feel about Benji? How do you feel about Benji?
How do I feel about Benji's awesome? He's my twin, both fraternal and identical. I don't know any other way to say it.
When you first met Benji, what did you think of him?
I heard yes. Oh,
shit. All right, hold on.
Do you like him more as a boss or an equal in work?
Yeah.
He was a kick-ass boss because we freaking used to go to the bank and then we used to just talk about bitches.
Bitches are nice, yes.
Music.
Music's good.
I'm just kidding. Benji never really talked about bitches.
No.
But he talks about shitty music a lot. That's true.
This is his goodbye video.
He does take a lot of heat for dubstep.
He takes a lot of heat. Like, I feel bad because he loves dubstep and, like, techno. And those are, like, two music genres that if people don't like them, they, like, extremely hate them.
Yeah.
I like techno.
No in between. You like it or
but
you
do not like
it.
Dubstep.
Yeah.
I like dubstep better than I like techno, I think.
I'll agree with that, but I don't really care for either of them a whole lot.
But see, like, I like Daft Punk, and I don't really consider them techno. They're something else. But if they're considered techno, I love Daft Punk.
So, is this, like, a present to him, or are you guys going to send it to him?
Speaking of presents for Benji, how would you feel if Philip cut off a dread and made it into a keychain and gave it to him before Benji left?
That'd
be so creepy. Like, he killed you. That's like one of the signs, like, of a murder.
Yeah, like, it's like a tattoo.
I like when he said, that's so creepy, like, it's a good idea. I don't know how to...
I remember when I first met Benji, he was very small.
Oh, yeah, so small.
But he was an authoritative figure in American Eagle, and he was good at it. It's very good.
And then
job.
He's a foreigner who doesn't look extremely foreign, so it kind of blew my mind.
Yeah, I didn't think he looked like he was from.
When he told me he was from South America, I was like, why are you white?
They just changed.
Yeah.
Sort of just like Mean Girls.
That's an awesome movie. I am sweating.
You guys can take
your
shirts off of me.
No.
I'm just
like. Oh wow.
Okay then.
No, keep them on.
Yeah.
I already saw your shirts off.
This party
off
just got weird.
That's what we were trying to do to you.
Oh. We're playing things later. This thing has to be on when we play things.
Shit! Okay, I swear to God, Ron had the best answer for things. It was like, what would you say to Eve if she freaking gave you, like, the bad apple? And he was like...
I eat apple!
He was like, he said, I got HIV. How do you like them apples? This guy over here.
It sounded funnier when you were there. Plus, you were like smoking.
No, I mean, it probably wasn't very funny.
It sounds funny now! I was talking about that shit at work today.
That sounds pretty funny.
Like, this Rod guy sounds like a dick.
You were both sabotaging each other, because each time you're like, I already know what he said, and then you would, like, say it out loud, and then both of you were like, shut up!
Everything that he writes, you think I know, he knows something that I don't know?
Yeah.
You think there's anything in this world that you know that I don't know? Already know?
No, reverse that.
You guys are like the guys from the Roxbury.
Is that a compliment?
No.
Thank you very much.
Don't do the head thing on this camera.
What's up?
The Night at the Roxbury head thing.
I don't know.
Don't touch it. It's just rusting up there.
What's that?
Flop a little penis.
Like, it will just
like
fall
over
off.
It, so that's all you see is like a little
penis. If you nudge it, it will fall.
On the bag over. Like a monster penis.
You won't know it's yours, Corey.
Yeah.
Thank you for that.
Edit that out.
Ron, your scalp's being cut off right now. I don't know if you know this or not.
He's like freaking...
Bring it up a little, can't you?
Ron, do you play basketball?
No.
Did you ever play basketball?
Yes.
Okay.
He plays basketball. That's his favorite sport.
I sucked. He fucking beat me in horse. I played soccer, wrestling.
Why is this?
I love soccer.
Are we trying to aim your guys' crotches or what?
No. Do you want to like?
I'll be honest. Justin? Back.
Ah. If I fuck it up more, I was trying to fix it.
At the Rick Center. It was the indoor one.
What is this suck? It's terrible. Balance. What the f- is that a weight?
His team was garbage, like the other people.
We almost beat the fucking team, though. And they were all from, like, whatever, Brazil or some shit.
Hey, remember that time, asshole? Remember we were at the casino?
Yes.
But I do.
Yeah, you know, that's good. Better. Go kind of like up.
Kind of like up.
There we go. There. There we go.
Is it staying?
Yeah, we're all on it now.
Why is there a weight on there?
It seems but like it's but he's not on it, and he's the most important.
According to that thing, he is.
He's on he's on it.
Yeah, but I'm on it.
How on there do you feel? That's a question.
I feel very on there.
That's okay. Perfect. That's perfect.
It's like...
It does stuff.
It's on like a pulley system.
I don't know.
You're on a pulley system.
I feel bad for us to watch this video. It's
so,
like
remember that time when I was like, I'm going to bet $20 on black. And then Ron's like,
I'm gonna
be a dickhead and put it all on red.
We went to the casino and we were feeling good because the day before I won $65.
Yeah, you left $65, which is nothing compared to like most people that game.
No, it was a lot.
So like a douchebag, I go out and buy everybody breakfast, you know, like, oh, I'm a money maker now. And I'm like, we gotta go back the next day. So we go back the next day, lose it all. But he bets on red and I bet on black and we're like, oh, someone's gotta win. And then it fucking rolled.
No, but I called it before. I put my money on black first. Ron's like, I wanna win money and I wanna watch Corey lose money.
Yeah.
I was like, now it's gonna hit green. What do you know?
And I was like, what? I know.
That's how much of an asshole this guy is.
Yeah, like I did this.
He was willing to sacrifice $15 just so I would lose 20.
But we both lost. And then he was like, Dying in the chair. I didn't say anything. He was a trooper.
I wasn't gonna say anything.
But you can read off his face.
He's being extremely polite and nice. You should have said you didn't want to go and just fell asleep. That's what
yeah,
I
you should
done.
Just.
You were like a trooper.
When we left, I wasn't that tired. But like when we got there, it was just like, boom.
If I were you, I would stay home and play fucking Tiger Woods. That's all I would have done.
Dude, that would be your ass. Play Tiger Woods. That's the only reason I
shut your face.
You guys play FIFA?
I'd fucking play FIFA.
Shit.
Do you have FIFA?
What is this video? Like, no one cares about your FIFA.
Oh, yeah, we're supposed to.
Yeah, Benji's going to hate. Are you going to edit this video?
No.
All right.
Oh, my God. Benji's going to be so bored.
He's kidding. But
does Philip make your nipples hard?
Is it weird that I'm asking?
This is all about Philip.
I mean, now I'm all upset at Shayla.
Why do we have
like,
weird
damn it,
showing
Shayla.
How awesome Philip is?
It's going to get weird before it gets awesome.
I mean, you
got. We already made the dick joke with that.
What is that?
I don't know.
It's a thermos
It's a
thermos that is supposed to obviously look very phallic.
It's a rocket. Okay. I see it. Can we light it on fire?
It's modern.
Oh my God, I forgot you were even here. I haven't seen you in hours. You too. Wow.
Come in the video.
Oh, no thank you. I'm good, but...
Dude, this girl, woman came into American Eagle, was like, oh, I went shopping in Evansville. I was like, get the French out of town.
Okay, well...
French out of town.
Bye, Benji. Miss you. You're awesome. And I hate Danielle. We were just talking about that, but that bitch
this video.
I like Danielle a lot.
This video actually.
Fuck you, man. Peace out.
No, fuck you, dude.
We should put this super soaker in the video. This thing is awesome.
I would not touch that.
Why?
I was told not to.
Touch it. I just touched it.
What's on it? What happened to it?
Benji
or why
just
can't
said,
I
don't touch it?
I just touched it. Oh my
all
god.
Alright, well, I think I'd rather drink with Missy in person than make this video.
I agree. We're going to go back downstairs and talk to you, Benji. Then we're going to bring you back up here and play things.
We enjoyed working for you. Eventually, your weird Jenny woman who was just scary.
But she was nice.
I liked her. She was very nice, but her life scared me a little bit.
No.
Lie.
When she sees
God.
This,
I think it was
she's
like
gonna
come
after you.
Whatever.
It's probably something worse.
She was
that.
Extremely
oh
nice,
God.
But I did meet her boyfriends like some of the
that
time.
Are the Lakers.
It was weird.
Oh, Lakers.
That's how I feel about the Lakers, Philip.
I'm sorry. If you stay here,
all
Heat
right.
fan, we're
we'll
done.
See you.
We're
we'll
I'm not
you.
An NBA fan at all, so
okay,
I'm, not,
right.
I'm not for your rival.
No, okay, Google Plus. We'll Skype him.
Oh,
bless you. We'll Skype you. We'll drink Alaska, Chicago together.
We'll come visit you when we're rich.
That's right. Kurt Warner bitches.
We'll cruise up to Chicago. Or to Alaska.
What's your tattoo say? Or is
we're
it
not
personal?
Gonna actually go.
It
to
says.
We're gonna take a
who gets a tattoo that's personal?
Oh,
come on now.
Hey, I don't know.
That's how
we club seals together.
Circa 8.
Oh yeah, we got a club seals.
It says, "The Lord is my light and salvation. Whom shall I fear above Him? None."
What's what?
Hebrew.
Are you
Jewish?
No, I studied Kabbalah for a little bit.
Oh, did you? Okay.
Yeah, I went to a couple Kabbalah temples.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Madonna does Kabbalah.
Yeah. Well, see, I was brought up. In a non-denominational church, but the pastor was Pentecostal, so it was kind of crazy. You know what I mean? The dancing, tambourines, Holy Ghost, all that shit. So whenever I got of age to decide, that was not what I was feeling.
Church.
Exactly.
Was
I was
it
like,
the New Kahala Temple?
Ron, stop it. God.
my favorite. Oh, yeah! It's my favorite delivery.
I've never been there because he won't let me
Thank
go.
You.
He keeps thinking it's Indian food, and then every time I'm like, let's go to New College.
It's not
like,
Indian. He's a doucher. He's a doucher.
It's not Indian food.
I don't even know what New College is. Is that named after the
Chinese? Chinese.
Yeah.
Well, I didn't know. You went there.
It's good. Anyhow, well, that's the reason. It's actually Psalms 27:1.
Awesome. This is a very awesome tattoo.
My
Thanks.
Boyfriend had Psalms in Hebrew.
Dude, there's a lot of Psalms
yeah,
tattoos
really
because Psalms is one of the best. I mean,
fuck.
Not one of the best. No,
this
I'm going to drop a religious bomb.
Yeah.
But I mean,
right,
it's
Benji,
one of the most
read.
Benji, you're not cool.
Yeah, most read,
Phil?
I would say. Most
I don't know what questions
versed.
To ask you about Benji.
We all care about Benji and we'll miss him.
Yeah.
Bye,
and
guys.
I think you'll miss him more than ever.
Yes.
Yes, you want
to confirm that?
You'll turn it off like,
yes,
no, none of this was true.
We'll probably miss you
more.
No,
this guy is super, because I'll see him soon. I'll see him like a couple 2 weeks.
Well, that's right, you're traveling.
Oh, you
yeah.
guys should have waited a little bit longer to go up there just so you could, you know what I mean? Like, if you go up right away, then you're going to miss him a lot later when you can't go up there.
That's true.
You should have waited like 2 months.
We're idiots. Oh, we can hit school. You're right, you should have.
Oh, yeah, you're right. I guess I didn't really think about that. So, no, you're right. I'm the idiot. Okay.
All right, we're out.
Brian,
you're freaking awesome. We're playing things tonight. You better come up with some funny shit. Even if you lose again, I don't give a shit.
I totally won. Does anyone remember that?
Listen, you stand. You gonna play things with us?
For sure. I've never
played
before.
Or
we'll I've never
things.
Played before, so.
It's fun.
You want to continue?
Yeah. Okay, well,
I feel like I'm robbing you of Benji time.
How's it been in 2 weeks?
I know.
So it's not that bad. I feel like I'm robbing you.
I'm so sad. Like, I'm pretty disappointed that I couldn't go. But that's okay.
We'll miss you, man. I was excited. We're like, what's this for? Hell yeah!
I was really excited too. I was conflicted about it though.
Come on.
Well, let's just say it might, if this trip were to have occurred a couple months from now, it would probably be fraternizing.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Like, I want to give some close ups, just like,
well,
close-ups of
closest get
Philip just screaming random words.
Okay.
I don't know if I can do that. I'm not.
Like, love, hate, faith. Benji. Those are the four words I want you to scream for this close-up shot.
Cat. I can still say Benji. Cat. Have my other. Can I have some other?
Yeah, you words? Can add in whatever you want. Bring this light a little closer to your face.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Is that bright?
Right.
No, just go ahead. And, yeah. Well, get comfortable, because you're going to be here for a minute. And I can see.
Is that really how I look? Oh my gosh.
Is that really how I look, he says.
Camel face.
A camel face? What does that mean, camel face?
I look like a camel.
Really?
Yeah.
You look like a camel?
I think I look a little bit like a camel.
Well, stop looking like a camel, man.
Did you know that a lot of Native African tribes think that the more you look like a cow, the more attractive you are?
Did not know that. Guess that brings me to...
So sometimes when you see those really protrude mouth people with the fucked up teeth, I always think about... You know, if you were in America, people would think that you were hot.
So, let's have you... Are you going to scream at the camera?
How else should I scream? I'm not a really big screamer.
I want you to just go fucking ape shit. Do you need to get right... Like, prepare yourself?
I can't go ape
Breathe.
Shit.
Breathe.
Just try it with Benji's name just a couple times.
I'm
going to
laugh.
Almost like you're calling him from downstairs.
Benji!
Like there's an emergency.
Benji!
Like someone's being stabbed.
Benji!
No, like, for real, like, Benji!
Holy sh! I can't do that.
You can't do it?
I can't.
Just
do
what?
It. I could slap you and then you could do it.
Benji! Benji! Milk Duds! Milk Duds! I don't.
Do it.
What?
Scream out love like that.
Like, you mean it, like, love!
Love! Milk Duds! Milk Duds! I can't. I'm sorry.
Keep going. It's good.
I don't know what else.
Dude, this can be like the titles for each scene.
Milk Dust is a child for a scene.
Growing up! Do it, please.
Tacos!
Yeah, think back at the subjects you guys talked about. Yeah, like, scream those out. Yeah, scream out. Whatever subject.
Coming of age!
Coming of age! Can you fake an orgasm for us right now? Like, just, like, go through the whole process.
Well, I think,
like, pretend like you're getting a hand job right now and just, yeah. Like, yeah, just, like, go through the whole thing. Because this is all about Andy Warhol. Like, Andy Warhol had
where's the dudes giving other dudes blowjobs.
Exactly,
the whole
but you
movie.
Never see it. But you see the experience of someone doing it. So go ahead and recreate that for us here. Just go ahead and give us the experience of, like, watching you.
I won't look if you, I understand that could be uncomfortable.
I don't like blowjobs, but...
You don't like blowjobs?
No.
Scream out blowjobs.
I'm not gonna... Blowjobs! I can't.
You
want
to play the louder game?
What's that?
The louder game. You say the word louder than the other person. And you just keep going till you're screaming.
Like, screaming scares me.
You never did that in, like, the lunchroom?
No, I don't like to... First of all, we used to have the 10-inch voices in the lunchroom. You scream, you're standing against the wall, not being able to eat with your friends. So, no, I never did scream louder game in the lunchroom, and you shouldn't have either. It's a choking hazard.
That's good, isn't it?
So, let's have a fake orgasm, then.
Let's see. That was... I think
you're not gonna get anything on
us. If my porn debut, I could just go down on you. Second wow. Egg is like brushing my hair for me.
I would say yes, but down here,
not everyone watch. I don't give a shit.
Down here is like not.
Yeah, we'll just do your face. Do you mean you want to do it? I totally. This is for Warhol.
No.
I want to be famous here, man.
I know that.
I'm not fucking around.
We'll be fine. No,
she's willing.
She doesn't have. No, she does not have to.
But we'll keep the camera up here. We won't point it down there.
I know that.
Totally cool.
I know that, but...
She'll make you fucking believe it. I believe it. She means this shit.
I know that, but no.
You won't do it. Okay, that's cool, that's cool. No, you don't have to. This is your thing, man. This is gonna go how you want it to go. So, here it goes.
I know that. Okay.
So you're gonna fake it for us, then?
Yeah, I think Benji needs to see this. Because, like, as you said earlier,
she is taking one for the team.
About each other.
Yeah, you are really not... He is really not thinking about this in Benji's perspective. If he were really thinking about Benji, he would be like, I will do this
well,
for
see,
Benji.
He's never taken CP 101, and at least I have that
right.
Rule of threes. We have to bring in
absolutely.
Sex one more time.
Fine.
Yeah.
I will fake an orgasm. I don't... Dad, like, makes sounds
like
or...
building up the
do whatever you
want to
do.
Coming.
This is your orgasm, man. How awesome do you want this to be? This is for Benji, man.
I don't really... Like, I don't
orgasms
Benji,
for Benji. It sounds
Benji
like a
would,
great movement. Doesn't it, though?
That's a movement. I could believe in that.
I don't really know. I don't really talk much. Okay. Let's see. If I was going to fake an orgasm...
Well, you don't have to fake it. I mean, actually, you could actually have an orgasm. And we could just film your expression.
I don't even want to touch my penis right now. There's nothing but sweat going on down there.
Mm. We got pants. A bathroom right over here. We wash you up. I'll get you a nice robe. You'd be like the princess and shit.
I'll walk you in my room. Okay.
Maybe let's start it.
Okay.
Come on. How does it start?
You can look. You need to see this. Everybody needs to see this.
I'll watch it on film. I want to save it for the moment of the screening of this.
A man will scream to orgasm. Okay. Let me get in the...
Yeah, it might help. Do you?
I mean, you know, do
how
this
does it work?
Helps.
Yeah. Yeah, how does it start? Is she going to have to tell you? Because obviously her telling you what she wants
no,
isn't
this.
Working.
Well,
gotta,
I'm not a hood rat, so I don't know how Phil's
she's not. She's not a hood rat.
Okay.
She's not
yeah,
a
how
rat.
Do you initiate a blowjob? That's how we should start this, really.
Like, if I was going to try...
how'd you convince a girl
like if we
to give you your first blowjob?
Yeah, and you know she wants to give you a blowjob. You just got to
figure
out... But
there's
that
awkwardness where you just...
Right.
You have to ask, like...
It's like, how do we... I want to go there, but how do I get there?
Both not saying it, but you're thinking it. And Philip, I know you've had this experience. Everyone has. So let's go. How'd you get this girl to bust down?
Hang on.
come on. Just one set. We're going to go from nothing to sexy time in 5 seconds flat. One statement. One word.
I'm not going to judge you on how you get your bitches.
I don't know how I did it, though, but...
Come on, seductive.
No.
Give it to us.
I'm a fake orgasm now. I can do that.
Well, first you got to seduce the orgasm out of your partner that's going to give you the orgasm. So you got to start this thing.
And
like,
you have to pretend
it's
like
not
going to
suck itself. I mean, if
lap.
You
want
to, you can just go there. You can just say it's not going to suck itself and then start. It's up to you. Like, that's a fine beginning to like a blowjob.
I don't think that's ever worked. In
yeah,
this
that's not really
jobs.
Appropriate. It's pretty rough. You can start a, you can light a candle or something.
No, we don't need to. It's hot as shit.
What kind of music do you listen to when you...
It's hot up here. Take your clothes off, baby.
You guys don't want to see that. Trust me, you guys don't want to see that.
Snap.
Okay, so I just like, oh, well.
This is almost like when they make us roleplay at work.
Right? I don't really know what
so
I would...
A customer comes up to you and you want her to suck your dick. What do you do?
Well, hell, you're welcome.
How do you like your jeans to fit, bitch?
Like a glove.
I guess I would say,
you need the artist jeans because your ass is fat!
I don't even know why, but... I don't really know how to start getting a blowjob.
You
want to
make a black snake mind.
You don't know how to start?
You want to make a black... That's a good movie. That's a really good movie.
Can you deliver it? You got to deliver the line, Philip.
You
got to deliver...
use that line...
I don't use lines!
When you use that line, that's good!
Well, no shit. If you're not using a line, you're stumbling.
What's
you can stumble
so
your way to ecstasy.
Okay, so you clearly don't say anything to the bitch before...
No, see, that's why I'm having trouble. It's unspoken.
So let's practice it.
Yeah,
what did she just say? No, what did you just say? You want to make a black slate? What did
black
you say?
Black snake moan.
I don't ever
practice
ask for them.
It. Well, then just try it now for us. We want to be entertained.
I can say that.
We're the audience here.
You
and
guys say it serious. Like, you're getting intimate with a girl now, Philip.
If we want to believe that you're getting an orgasm, we got to believe that... someone would give you an orgasm according to the line you deliver.
I'm completely awkward.
Come on, deliver
sex,
it.
So I was just gonna. What's up, baby girl? Wanna make a black snake moan? Maybe. I would never use
that. That would
never
not
say
work. That would be like. You could be like hot.
I didn't even feel
like,
right
not.
Saying that.
Why don't you practice it? Come on, do it again. Come on.
Would you be interested in making my black snake moan?
You know, you ever seen the movie Chocolat?
Chocolat. Chocolat.
Yes. It was French, right? And it was
Johnny
Depp, right? And he said he delivered a line, and I've used that 100 times. You want me to come around sometime and take that squeak out your door? And he said, I'll come around sometime and take that squeak out your door. And you knew that squeak in her door was that itch, man, and he was going to fix that itch. That I've
one.
Used that and it's effective as hell. You should have some of that, man. I mean, it's.
I heard a really good one the other day. I forgot what it was though.
Mm.
If you were attracted to me and you wanted me to suck your dick, what would you say? Or do?
Well, okay. I can tell you what I would do because I don't ever really say it.
Right, because you said.
Yeah, let's pretend like she's already. Let's pretend like she's willing to suck your dick.
Or it could be someone else, Brittany. No, that would be weird.
That's freaking way weird.
That would be really weird.
Ew.
She's gonna kick my ass if she ever hears that, but that's okay.
She will.
It's incest. Okay. There's a girl.
I mean, you can even look at me and practice. Like,
yeah, why don't you sit over here? Sit closer.
No, I don't want to be on film.
She all right.
Be
on film.
I think it's very important that the interviewers never saw. All right.
Like Chris Hansen. Okay, so I would, we'd be in the throes of passion, obviously.
Right, we'd be making out.
Making out, hot and heavy. Mm-hmm. And then...
Go ahead and make out with your
like,
hand. You can make out
I'd
with your
like,
hand and be intimate.
I'd be like, damn, you're a good kisser. That's how I would start it.
Oh, yeah. Okay, so she says you're a good kisser.
So I've initiated the conversation. Like, now you gotta talk back.
Thank you. You know, I tried. I've been practicing on my teddy bear since I was a young of age. I watch a lot of movies, so I think that... Thank you so much. And then we start making out again, being hot, heavy, and intimate. And then, eventually, I will remove her shirt, because that's just the way I roll.
Do you feel up the shirt a little bit?
Of course I do. You can't go put the turkey in the oven, that filling inside the oven to see if there's any grease buildup, because if there is, the vents will get blocked and the turkey won't cook that well.
Do you always do this much talking?
I would think you would want the oven greased.
You definitely want the other.
Okay, movies. Well, in practice, no, I'm not. I'm not having sex with you. I'm supposed to get a BJ.
Oh, that's right.
You got it.
So I get nothing out of it. I just get my shirt off.
No.
So
no,
I'm
gonna
let you see my Buddha belly.
No, see.
While I suck your dick.
No. See, you don't understand. As a gentleman, I always go first. If I want to get my fellatio, I'll make sure I go down on a girl for at least 10 minutes. That's all I will.
You think you're good at that?
Am I good at oral sex? I think I'm okay. Hold on. However, I can't stick my tongue out. True story. I can't stick my tongue out.
Try.
Can't stick my tongue out. See, I can't stick my tongue out.
Are you kidding me?
No, I'm not. I'm not.
Do you have tongs like, in the kitchen?
Your, but just put your fingers up and just like lick between them. Like that's
like there's delicious grape sugar.
Yeah, oh, it's right in between.
Fun dip, right here.
Oh, it's right there. There it is.
Go
get it.
Go.
Oh yeah, you can. Yeah.
I can kind of stick my tongue. I can't stick my tongue.
You must be awful.
I'm
just kidding.
I'm amazing.
Philip, I'm sorry. I'm messing with you. For
that's
real.
All right. No, I'm amazing. I've had no complaints.
So we're still talking.
Sorry.
I thought we're gonna do this fake orgasm thing.
Yeah, we're getting there.
Okay. Are we building up? I mean, because you're doing a lot of talking.
No. The talk is I'm telling you what I would be doing.
Right.
And then I'll go down and girl for at least 10, maybe 12 minutes. I don't know.
Right, we've been going on for at least that
long.
Does
she have to get off?
Are you gonna?
No, eventually she'll just stop me.
No.
Maybe she wants to give you a blowjob.
Fine.
We still haven't gotten to the blowjob.
No,
maybe she
okay.
really wants to get down your pants.
So eventually
maybe
she'll.
A party
eventually she'll stop
coming.
Me and then she'll come and get down my pants.
Phil, may I critique your sex to improve it?
Let me hear it.
Get the blowjob first, and then go down on her, because then you're not super turned on from the blowjob, and if it happens to turn into sex, you've got that time period to kind of cool down, so you don't blow your load right away.
Yeah, but I don't like... I really don't like blowjobs. I really don't do that.
See, girls... The reality with girls, though, is that a lot of girls like to give blowjobs, and sometimes they don't even want to do sex, because, like, it might be the time of the month, there's a million things going on with the woman, and... It might not be happening, but they can always do that.
Like,
so you gotta be lenient to like let them have some fun.
Yeah,
with you.
But I would tell her you don't have to give me a blowjob. You can really just give me a handjob. Then you go to sleep and watch the Flintstones.
You like handjobs more than blowjobs?
Yeah, I don't like handjobs. Yeah, especially if they're done right and correctly.
What? There's a right on what?
Yeah, there's a right way.
Tell us all about it.
The twist. I've had a handjob where.
I already cracked my wrists earlier, not thinking about it.
I had a terrible hand job, and like my dick was chafed because she was awful at it, and she didn't know how to do it right. And I walked around with a limp for like a whole week because she didn't know how to give a right hand job. So yeah, there's a right and wrong way to give a hand job, obviously.
One time, Ken snagged himself in a zipper, and so he had a scab, and the scab came off in my mouth.
That's nasty. Did you swallow it?
Yeah. Swallow other shit from his body. What's the scam?
It's even as salty, isn't it?
To be honest, I've really only swallowed, like, Ken's. No, that's not true. I've only swallowed, like, 2 grams of semen before. Mm-hmm. And Ken's, like, really healthy. Drinks a lot of water. So I've had good cum experiences.
That's what she
I've
said.
I've probably only swallowed semen. I could count it on my hands, probably. Because he'd always, like, just...
Would you enjoy it though?
Sorry.
Yeah. It's fine.
There, you know, there is a resistance that we have that like there's some sort of taboo.
Mm-hmm.
You know that like it's still just there, right? Mm-hmm. And like no matter how much, no matter how much it's wanted to be given, it's as much it's wanted, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like you want that experience, yeah. As much as you want it. But you'd rather have a hand job, though.
Probably.
I see.
Okay, so we'll just...
Why not? Why would you rather have a hand job than a blow job?
No, I don't...
Have you had bad BJ experiences? Do you think that might be it?
No, I just... Like, I don't... Like my situation is cool, but, like, I couldn't see myself sucking somebody else's dick. So why would I want somebody else to suck mine? I feel
terrible.
If you
want to go down on a girl, you like going down on a girl. Like, you're prideful of...
And you suck your own dick.
Yeah, it's my own dick. Yeah.
What's so shameful about your dick?
So when you're hooking up with a girl for that I'll give you props and say our. That's her dick. That's not your dick. That's
dick. You got to figure that out first.
It's her dick.
It's her dick.
You are a tool.
I'm just. Was my body then? It was her
well,
dick.
It's like still you, but it's like, you know.
It's her dick. It's belong. And so that would be my vagina then.
Yeah, that's your pussy.
Okay. Well, okay.
That's why we're sharing.
Well, okay. I'm sorry. But, okay, you know what? I only like a BJ if I just got out of the shower. I'm really self-conscious.
So you're self... Okay.
That's yeah, like I don't, like...
All right. Well, here, we'll put you in the shower with another girl.
I don't like have shower sex.
But no, you're getting a shower head.
I don't like shower head.
How do you shower if you don't have a shower head?
No, I don't like...
I went...
That's real good. That was good though. That was good.
Slammed you into that wall, face first.
Yeah, I don't like shower sex.
Well, okay, Philip. It's the perfect environment. You just got out of the shower. You're clean. Maybe you're at a spa.
Did someone
vacation.
Just put talcum all over your ass?
Do we like have to like? Get,
yeah, you're get, perfect.
Take your orgasm.
Okay.
Already.
I don't know how to. I don't say much.
Come on.
I don't make noise.
Just give it to us. Give us what you got. Okay. I mean, the person seeing this wants to know the reality. What
okay.
are they dealing with?
I'll give you my vinegar face or my cum face.
Oh, I really.
Well, we
gotta
get started. No, we gotta start with you. We gotta cue this thing up.
Story
you gotta like deliver your line. There's gotta be a line. You gotta deliver something to spark the experience.
Even
okay?
if it's like oh.
I mean,
all right.
Unless
I
you're
it.
Just like
I got
if you're just pointing at your penis.
I got it.
Suck
I got it.
It.
I got it. I got it. My orgasm. Sorry.
Well, no, you got to deliver your line first, though. We haven't.
No, there's a line that comes afterwards.
But wait, no. How do we get to the orgasm unless you deliver your line? Like we don't even have a new we don't have a blowjob initiated yet.
Oh, you? Am I wearing a condom?
We haven't gotten even that far. We're still.
You want me to go through the whole time? You want to go through the whole sexual
just,
experience with Phil?
Just, we,
okay.
We just want the line. We just want the line. What's the line? What's the? You know, it's not going to suck itself. What are you going to deliver to like? Start this because every girl wants it, right? You gotta like,
that's
you want to give
like,
away, but you want it
I
to be
mean,
taken, right? I mean,
for real,
any
like,
self-respecting girl is gonna expect you to put something out there.
If we're not asked, like if you don't initiate it, like we feel slutty doing it.
It's dirty.
Like
could you imagine?
You have to initiate it. Like
it's a vulnerability. You're making yourself vulnerable when you're asking for it. When you make yourself going, I really want you. That's like that's what makes it happen. But you gotta be willing to do it.
Huh?
Is that true, Alyssa?
Well, I just know, like, guys have judged me before because I'm not afraid to just go for the dick. And, yeah, you know. We're both thinking it, but because I tend to hook up with pussy guys, they don't initiate it, so.
So you give them a break. You give him a bite. Like he didn't make himself vulnerable.
Yeah,
you go
I
for
mean,
it
like,
anyway.
I mean, like if they're not, if they're
and then they
not,
hold it against
if
you.
If we're making
they?
Out for 10 minutes and their hand has not been on my pussy, I'd go for the dick because it's like okay, clearly this guy.
Yeah,
is,
I mean, are we wasting time here? Right.
Yeah.
Come on, get with it.
That's freaking awesome. Okay, so I was.
Do it now! Hurry, someone's coming.
Oh.
No, we gotta have the line.
Oh
though.
My
you gotta
gosh.
Deliver a line.
I don't have
you
a line.
Get...
Oh my gosh.
Woo!
Do that passionately.
Oh, I do. And then I do that, and then.
Oh, that was enough?
Yeah.
She's gonna go, oh, I just wanna suck your dick.
I thought we.
Phil just orgasm already.
I just did!
Do it again!
Gotta get in the right.
I still want to hear the line. I haven't heard
I don't think
the,
he has
I,
one.
I don't
like,
have
I think
a line.
Maybe
well, you
got to
do it for us. This is an audience right
I
here
almost,
inside this camera.
I almost feel like this is what Philip does.
This could be your future wife here
he not just
in this camera.
He near his bulge.
Okay.
And then he just kind of, you know, like gives the head nod, like the look.
You know that.
And then,
oh, okay.
then they know.
I feel like a rapist
awesome.
If I do that.
You feel like a rapist. Okay, so what do you
so
do?
So you got to like, come on. What would you imagine? What's your fantasy? What's your fantasy for the perfect thing to say then? What would be the best thing you could possibly say? Not what you want.
Am I like the best line for?
Yeah.
Okay.
We want it, man.
I feel like this is not about Benji that much. Okay.
This is totally about
Benji.
This is exactly what Benji wants, man.
We're going somewhere.
This is for Benji. Benji would be proud to hear your line, man. I promise you.
Like, I know you're not gonna judge me. And I don't know, like, I can't, okay. Have a line. I really don't have. I don't know.
Well, use one of the lines. God. What did you already? You've given him like three lines.
Blackskin Mom really didn't work.
I can't. Try it.
Can you see me saying that? How about you let this black snake bone? I'm not that clever.
Slow it down. Slow it down. You got to work it.
I can't coach him. I'm sorry. I mean,
she's willing.
He's beyond repair.
You got.
I'm kidding.
Come on, keep trying. She don't listen to that. She's still here. Okay. If they haven't left, they're still available. Try it out. If she believes in you, you win.
I believe in you, Philip. Like you can make this BJ happen. Okay. Or hand job or nothing.
You got to make that black snake moan, man.
Okay.
You gotta let it growl.
All right. I got nothing. I'm sorry, I can't do it.
Do the black snake moan.
What about, like, you wanna put a penis in your mouth?
I wouldn't say that.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's not gonna suck itself.
I feel like you would say, I feel like you would make a joke, like, so is this, am I gonna get a happy ending? Like, something funny like that.
I would make a joke, but I don't know what the joke would be. I haven't had fornications in like 6 weeks.
Stop it. Stop. When you watch this, you might have just had sex. So, you never know.
Oh, okay, sorry.
Yeah.
Okay,
come on. Black Snake Moan, you gotta work on it.
It's not gonna suck itself,
or, you know?
Ken doesn't talk, so I don't have anything.
See? Thank you! See, I'm not the only guy, so I can't even see myself. Ken's awesome. I can't even see myself saying that.
Right?
Like, I don't really say anything. What would you say?
But you're hearing what a woman wants to hear.
It's just like heavy breathing.
Do you want to give the woman what you want, or do you want to give the woman what she wants to hear? Because you're getting told.
Benji what he wants, which is an orgasm on camera.
There we go. What would Benji say then? What would Benji say to a girl?
All right.
That's good.
So here we go.
What?
If you're going to make be this difficult, Philip, this is the situation. Are you ready for this?
Yes.
You're in the back stock room.
Okay.
With the perfect woman. I can't tell you who she is. Only your deepest, darkest penis.
Zooey Deschanel.
Wants, knows.
Zooey Deschanel. Go ahead.
Zooey Deschanel is in the back room with you.
Mm-hmm.
And she's humming. And she's humming one of her songs.
Okay.
And it just sounds so melodic.
She's crazy.
And she's wearing this tight little romper.
Oh my gosh.
With you know, cute little flats, maybe a little tank top underneath layered. Her hair is down and wavy like it
always is. Is she on her period?
She is not on her period.
Okay, go ahead.
And she's just humming back there. And you guys are alone for some reason. I don't know. Maybe you're the man around you.
We got locked into the mall and we're stuck in the stock room.
Or
it's an earthquake. Go ahead.
The mall was like deserted, no one was shopping that day, and there was a tornado, so you had to go in the back.
I'm running with this, let's go.
And she's just like, you know, humming, she smiles at you, and she looks up, and she says, Philip, I've just always thought about you.
Then we start making out then. We'll start making out then.
Right, so she's making out. And I mean, really, there wasn't a better time for you to save your best friend. Get me out of that shot. Oh, I can't. I don't want
to. So, where were we at?
We just started making out.
Benji, can you help?
So, you guys are making out?
Yeah, we just started making out.
And she says, Philip, I really want to do these things to you.
Let's do them. I don't understand, like, what the problem is.
So,
you got to deliver a line.
Well, let's go. Let's do it. We could have been doing this the whole time. Why the hell did it take?
Say it like that.
No, that's not. That's gonna buzzkill. That's a buzzkill. Instant buzzkill.
So she says.
Why aren't we already doing it? Instant buzzkill. Come on, regroup yourself.
So she says, Philip, I want you really bad, but I want to do things to you first. That's what she says.
Oh, that sounds awesome. Let's do them.
How are you gonna make yourself vulnerable?
So she goes for it. She takes your dick out.
Yes.
Go. There you are. Start it.
You think she just grabs you? Is that what happens?
She just grabs
your belt buckle.
She starts giving me.
You gotta say something.
So she's just standing. I think she casually grabs his belt buckle.
Oh,
let's
do
it.
Now what happens? She grabs your belt buckle. What do you say? Bam! Snap.
She's,
Does she just pause until I say something?
She just grabs. I mean,
no,
come
like
on.
She's like, okay.
Remember
so
the rule. Every
okay,
woman is
so
going to wait till you're vulnerable.
Against, like, the wall right
yes,
there.
Yes.
And she's like grabbing it at your crotch, starting
yes,
to kneel.
Uh-huh.
Do you say anything, or you just look at her?
I just wait for her to begin.
You would just be quiet.
Yeah, just while she's starting to... she's going to give me fellatio, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll just wait. I'm not going to say anything to ruin it. I think, like, any woman
less
who messes around with me knows that it's going to be awkward, all right? No, I'm an awkward person, so I'm not going to make it even more awkward by saying some stupid shit.
Okay, so she's on her knees, and she's like getting your cock out or whatever, and
okay,
she says something to you, like, I'm so hot for you, or baby, I'm so wet right now, something along those lines, where you have to say something back, or it's just kind of awkward.
You already know what I'm going to say.
What are you going to say?
I'm going to say thank you!
You're going to say thank her? Oh my god, Philip! You can't thank a girl for being wet!
Oh, I'm sorry, I forgot about the part. I would try. I'm just gonna say, oh shit, that's awesome! Let's keep going. I don't know what else to say!
Come on.
God, I don't
come
know.
Come on,
no,
this moment is hot.
Everybody
this
used
is
to
happening
know this
now.
If you sign up, if you're messing around with Philip Sanders, you're gonna know that it's gonna be kinda awkward because I'm an awkward person just normally. And one of the most awkward things you can do is have sex. So I'm going to be awkward. I'm not going to say much. I'm just going to be like, oh, that's awesome. That's great. I'm going to be very polite. I don't
but,
know.
But why don't you say, come on, get yourself in sexy time now. This is sexy time.
It's
I'm happening.
Polite
it's
in sexy
happening
time. I'm polite.
Okay, well, what does polite sound like then?
Thank you. Oh, that's awesome. Great.
Yeah? But that's
okay
not how you would say it. You'd be like, thanks, baby. Or something like
isn't
that.
Isn't there anything? Come on, don't you?
Zoe or...
Yeah, there's a different tone of voice.
Get your tone going. Like,
yeah,
no, I'm dead serious. Like, somebody has... Well,
don't you whisper? I mean, because, like, there's a whispering that happens
oh, okay,
during
okay
sex. Come on, there's
the
a heaviness.
Going on. Like,
oh, yeah, you're listening to every tone.
Your cock is about to go in Zoe Deschanel's
yeah
mouth, dude. You are throbbing
yeah
for
if
that
you hum, she can feel you.
Dude,
so, you know, you gotta, like...
Oh, man. Thank you. I appreciate it.
I want to be between your tonsils. Nothing
I
like that?
Say, no.
No, you wouldn't
that's
say
vulgar
that?
That's vulgar. I'm sorry. Like, I watch
don't
a lot.
You think she would want that?
Maybe I'm the doctor. You need a throat cold.
What? Hello. I would imagine...
Wouldn't that be good if I had a dick? I would get sucked out of my dick. Once in the morning, once at noon, and once at night. I would just get it done. Look at me with all my lines.
I'm just,
need is some good lines, and you can...
I'm not that kind of person. I can't do that. I'm not that kind of guy. I can't really
what does that
come
mean
out with...
What kind of guy is that?
Well, that, like,
I thought you were the kind of guy that's getting your dick sucked by who?
Zooey Deschanel. Yeah,
yeah,
but
I know
who that is! I'm just saying, like...
500 Days of Summer.
Oh, yeah.
She's hot. She's so hot.
You
yes,
better, you better man up and get some of that.
I am right now. I'm currently
all right, she's
doing...
got your belt buckle, and we're still deliberating on what's happening next.
The dick
next
is being pulled out.
Is she
speak
pulling your dick out, or are you apologizing to her?
No, she's... I thought
are
she
you
pulled...
Are you thanking her?
Are you... You're welcome. What are you giving her?
Are
what,
you gonna say?
What's happening next?
Oh, that feels
I'm
good.
I'm probably gonna
oh,
say, oh, that feels good. Yeah, I will
are
say,
you
oh, that feels good.
Okay.
Oh,
that
feels
good.
Good.
That feels good. That's.
But I think if you said it in that tone, like she'd probably think it was sarcastic.
Oh, okay. I got you.
Yeah.
Oh, that feels good.
Keep going. There's your start. That's your line.
There's your sexy voice right there.
Yeah, it feels.
Go with it. Mm-hmm. Till she makes you.
Come on, close your eyes and be there. She's.
Because you're not going to have your eyes open weirdly mm-hmm staring at the stock shelves.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, come on, let's get back in that zone. So we've got
okay
over the hump. You've got a line.
Okay, okay. I'm
you can look over her head and see that her firm ass and that
yeah, are you
going
to grab her head and...
Wait, she's just giving me oral sex. We're not going to...
You
lead
can
to...
fuck her if you want, but you're...
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
No, you're going to get your nut off in her mouth first, and then you're going to automatically have an instant heart on. That's what happens in this fantasy.
Okay, I got you.
So,
okay. And then...
Oh, hold on! That's it?
That's all I would say! I wouldn't even
it
keep saying that for that long!
I mean,
long
she wants... You know, she... Do you enjoy giving a girl an orgasm?
Yeah, it makes
do
me
you
feel...
Do you imagine that a girl
it validates
would enjoy...
my existence.
Yeah, do you think that... Don't you want to validate her existence? Like, if...
So when
if she was giving
like
you a blowjob...
telling you how good it feels when you're, like, down on her, like, doesn't that encourage you?
Oh, it does.
So don't you want to encourage the girl?
I guess you're right. I never really thought about it that way.
Well, there you go.
But I mean, I don't usually, but I guess mm-hmm now I will. Now
that we're recording it, yeah,
yeah
you
now,
got to.
Now I'm going
to
give her some... We're like, oh, man,
yeah,
that's awesome.
That's what we want to see. Yeah, we want to see. That's like, awesome. How much
that's
do you
great
give back, Phil? Come
that's
on, great give it to her. Give it to her good.
This feels just real good.
get dirty with her. She's a little dirty, man.
Yeah, yeah. Use your hands. She's got a head. She's got a back of a
oh,
head.
Oh, I don't do that. I feel bad when I do that.
Oh, yeah, you should you get used
no,
to
no,
that.
No, I feel
what
bad.
If you, like, just
Zoe
press
likes
her
it.
Hair out of her
oh,
face.
Yeah.
Yeah,
like,
yeah. She wants
hold
you to
her
pull
hair,
her hair.
Like,
oh, yeah.
Yeah,
help her
hair.
Yeah, grab it. Yeah, her neck. Harder. Yeah.
Apparently, Phil has a 3-foot dick because her head's all the way up here.
I do.
Pringles can.
Once you pop, the fun doesn't stop.
That's been my phrase because that's true. Once you
so wait, we're not done. Are we still having this orgasm?
Yeah. Okay.
Come
oh, it feels good.
It's been a fucking hour to get this
I know.
Out of you. It's
come on.
Not, I want to go.
Let's
the
get
party.
In this.
Okay.
Let's do this orgasm. Let's. Do
I don't
this.
Have. I don't have an orgasm.
Come on, do it. That, my friends.
Philip, you hate it! Why didn't you think of it?
I probably would never. Because probably if, you, if I would have said that, let's say I just came in her mouth, and I would have said, oh, let's get you another milkshake after the one I just gave you. She'd probably spit and, like, it'd get all over my jeans. Cause
maybe
it's kinda
she
funny.
Would spit anyways because she's a dirty whore and she'd probably, like, dribble all over her chin and then
yeah.
She'd. Wipe it off.
It sounds like if you were talking
Zoe
about milk.
Zoe Deschanel is not a dirty whore.
She is so slutty. I would fuck the shit out of her.
Yeah, it doesn't mean she's a whore.
No, she's dirty.
Okay, so yeah, I don't really have orgasm sound. I, yes. Okay.
We went through all this.
I mean, you don't say dirty like it's a bad thing. You,
no.
You're saying
it's
like it's a good thing.
It's so natural. I don't think it's awkward at all. I can't imagine it being awkward. Like, yeah, it's awkward, like, because you're nervous, like, what's going to happen, but, like, actual.
What?
Doing it is not awkward.
Like, I watch porn, and, like, I hear these guys say these things, and it's just like, oh, that's kind of rude. Can't be talking to women like that. I feel bad. And so, like, I can't see myself saying the same shit they say. I just feel awkward about it.
I mean, porn is
What about those girls? Those girls are, you think those porn girls are, like, weak and submissive women? I mean, they're
okay,
pretty,
I'm just saying, like, if
pretty,
you're gonna,
like, expressive and
and they're
kind of,
like,
sure
demeaning
of themselves.
To men, too.
That's
like,
true.
Oh, they treat men like
men just
objects.
Don't see
we
it
are
that
nothing.
Way.
Oh, yeah. We don't get it, but it's
I
true.
I watched Caden Cross for an hour today on, she does this thing called Caden's Review, and today they were reviewing Ben and Jerry's ice cream. And she taught, like, the guy will, like, ask her questions
mm-hmm.
in between, like, the ice cream eating. And she was like, well, no, really, like, I don't believe monogamy is natural, and I don't think I'll ever date seriously because I won't meet a normal guy that has a dick that will satisfy me. It's basically what she said. And
who's this?
Caden Cross. She's a contract star for Digital Playground. She started on twisties.com. Her way up. Her last big movie was Babysitters 2, which came out at the end of June.
You're like the IMDb of porn.
No, that's not true. The Masseuse 3. She played a psychotic, multiple personality girl.
You're like IMDb of porn.
Well, we're running out of battery juice right now.
Okay.
So we're. Did we just pop? Did we just
yeah.
have our money left?
Bust
money
your
shot?
Fucking nut on Zoe's face.
Come on,
let's
do the fake. Come on, give us the orgasm. Give us your full on, like.
All right, this is obviously
this
fake.
This has got to be hot.
This is gonna be fake because I don't ever.
I think we know it's fake.
Okay. Oh, thank you.
that's how the movie's gotta start. Image, we got it, dude.
Love it. All right.
F you guys.